Karlie Kloss. I'll be teaching coding this week on Celebrity Substitute.
How can you use code to win over even your most difficult friends? Believe it or not, it's actually possible. My name is Tara Tran, and I teach computer science in New York City. Today, we'll be learning about how to use code to organize data. But teaching from home has been a little bit difficult, so joining me to teach this lesson is a very special celebrity substitute, Karlie Kloss.
Hello, I'm your celebrity substitute, Karlie Kloss.
Hi, Karlie.
Hi, Tara. I'm so excited to help you out in teaching this lesson today.
In our previous lesson, you had the best, scarily good robot voice.
I'm Robot Karlie. Oh, thank you. Yes, Robot Karlie, at your service if you need. In our last class, we introduced the concepts of thinking like a computer and creating functions to avoid repeating work unnecessarily. Today, we're going to show you how you can use arrays, a really useful way of organizing data in coding.
Is that a jar full of cheese?
Yeah, why?
I don't think that's what jars are for.
I beg to differ. Jars are just containers. I can put anything in them. The same goes for any of these cabinets and drawers. I can use them to store anything I want, and I can change what's stored in them whenever I want. All of these cabinets and drawers and jars are real-world examples of a coding concept called a variable. A variable is a storage location for information within a program. Variables come in a lot of forms. They can be used to store numbers or text or lots of other more complicated types of data. When you create a variable in code, you give it a name. Just like I might decide to call this jar, jar, because why not? You can also assign a value to it, which is the same thing as putting something into this jar. Right now, the name of my jar might be jar, but the value of it is cheese. I can also easily change the value of this variable, jar, by dumping out the cheese and filling it with fortune cookies. Now, if I wanted to check on the value of jar, I would see that it is fortune cookies because that's what it's currently holding.
What about these other ingredients that I see on your island? That's quite an array.
These are all ingredients to my famous Karlie's cookies. I could treat every one of these containers as a separate variable with a different name, and their values would be whatever they're holding.
Karlie, did you eat some milk chocolate chips just then?
Only dark. I'm a dark chocolate kind of girl. But yes, I'm eating all the props. But because these are all part of one group, the ingredients for my cookies, I'd rather just keep them together as one long list and give that list a name. I want to call this whole thing cookie ingredients. And when I do that, I've just created what we call in coding an array. An array is an ordered list that a coder can use to collect multiple items or variables together and easily manipulate them without losing track of each item within the array. It's kind of like if your friend rolled up to your house and instead of saying, hey, nice four wheels and engine and chassis and sheet metal and windows and stereo, you can just say, nice car.
Exactly. We actually use arrays all the time without realizing it.
Like when you make a music or video playlist. That's an array. Think about how you can add and remove videos or reorder them. These are all things you can also do with arrays in coding.
Or when you shop online, the website is often using an array to store and keep track of your shopping cart. So now that we understand some other real-world applications of arrays, let's get back to the one in front of you. You decided to give the name cookie ingredients to this array of ingredients for your cookies.
An array isn't just a pile of items thrown together. It keeps track of where all of its elements are in relation to each other, because each element has a number called an index. That index represents where it lives in the array. Like your home address. If the array is the street, the index is the house number. When we put all of these recipe ingredients in an array in code, you can picture them being laid out like this. Each ingredient is a separate element in the array.
In computer science, we count things like this, starting with an index of 0. So entry 1 is actually the second thing in the list.
That sounds confusing at first, I know, trust me. But it makes a lot of sense in a lot of ways. We start number lines at 0 in general. Imagine you're running a marathon. When you take off from the starting line, you start at 0 miles, not 1. Although it'd be nice if you started at 1. Each number tells you how far you are from the start. So the first entry is index 0 and then index 1, and it continues like that.
So to see how you can manipulate this recipe array using coding, Karlie, I'm going to have you be our oh-so-accommodating host and cook, and I'm going to be the friend you're cooking for. Just to warn you, I can be a really picky eater.
Bring it on.
You look like you've got a lot of ingredients for these cookies. Can you tell me exactly how many different things there are?
Yes, and one of the easiest operations you can perform on an array is finding the number of elements it contains, its length.
Oh, so the same command that an online store might use to display the number of items in your shopping cart.
Exactly. So to answer your earlier question, the recipe has 12 elements, a length of 12. And looking at the recipe now, how is it? All ready to go? Or are you feeling picky?
Well, I do love nutmeg. Can you add that?
Okay, a little unusual for this cookie recipe, but I guess it could work. All right, I'll grab the nutmeg, and if you're coding that, you can push a new item onto the end, which also increases the array's length by one. So cookies ingredient push nutmeg. So now we have nutmeg, and the number of ingredients is now 13. Good to go?
Not quite. I don't want those dark chocolate chips. Do you think we can swap them for milk chocolate?
Of course. Let's look at where the dark chocolate chips currently sit in the array. You can see that they're at index 6. Knowing that, you can use a command called splice to change the value that sits at that location in the array. To use splice, we specify the index where we want to insert something, the number of items to be replaced, and also the actual items we want to insert. We know we want index number 6, and we're overwriting one item, dark chocolate, so we can send the splice command to the number 6, the number 1, and the actual value, milk chocolate. And there we go. The dark chocolate chips have been replaced with milk chocolate. So Tara, can I take this array and use it to start baking now?
Yes, Karlie, you absolutely can. So as you can see, you can use code to win over your friends. In that demonstration, we learned that variables are named places to store information, and that a list of them is easiest to handle as an array. We learned how to find an array's length and how to add or change specific elements in it using commands like push and slice. All that's left is to put these in the oven. I know I've been a really picky eater, but I am craving these cookies. Am I still invited over?
Absolutely. Tara, you're always welcome. Class is over and you did great. Want to get some extra credit? Hit the subscribe button so you'll never miss a celebrity substitute lesson right here on YouTube.